And our top story, News 8 is on the stimulus watch, keeping track of how Washington is spending your money. Good evening, everyone. I'm Brian Roach.
I'm Janelle Stelson. President Obama's stimulus program was designed, as you know, to create or save jobs. But a new study shows the stimulus only did half the job. News 8's Matt Barcaro has been following the money.
The findings are bleak. A new analysis from the Associated Press finds stimulus-funded road and bridge projects had no effect on local unemployment.
I don't think that there's a long-term reach for this program and job creation.
Bob Latham is with the Associated Pennsylvania Constructors, a trade group representing road and bridge builders.
We had members all across the Commonwealth that, as a result of that stimulus, did not lay off people that they would have laid off last year.
But the program's success as a job creator is in doubt. The latest numbers from the governor's office show stimulus-funded infrastructure projects required 5,800 jobs in October, 3,800 in November. It's not known how many jobs were new ones.
Stimulus-funded projects may have brought some people back to work, but they provided very few opportunities for people laid off from other industries.
You don't necessarily shift a factory worker to a construction worker overnight.
Latham says unless more money is distributed, the outlook for this year could be grim. Most stimulus projects are already out to bid and a one-time shot in the arm.
They do fix some roads and they fix some bridges which are needed, but it doesn't allow PennDOT to plan on a long-term basis.
On the Stimulus Watch, Matt Barcaro, News 8.
Latham and other construction experts are pushing Congress to approve a recurring funding plan over 5 or 6 years. They say that would provide more long-term job growth.